There's no possible way to contain all of the crazy excitement in a full day of world-class play in simply 4 to 5 minutes, but I'll do my best. This is the Stiga Daily Review. The hearts of Morizono and Oshima were shattered in the men's doubles quarterfinals by the hot favorites Zhang Jike and Xu Xin. The Japanese duo had two match points to cause a massive upset, but their inexperience cost them as the Chinese powerhouses closed out one of the best matches of the tournament so far, 4-3.
And there it is. Jujin Jankika, what a victory.
The incredible run of the Brazilian pair Kazuo Matsumoto and Thiago Monteiro was halted by the Korean pair Lee Sang-soo and Seo-hyun Duck. The Brazilians had a big chance of becoming the first ever Latin American World Championships medalists, but they fell just short against the dangerous Koreans. It was a battle of Europe in the women's doubles quarterfinals as women from four different countries fought it out on just one table. Netherlands' Li Jie and Poland's Li Qian were too good for Turkey's Humelek and Spain's Shen Yanfei. And their reward is a date in the semifinals against the Chinese dream team of Ding Ning and Li Xiaoxia. Jun Mizutani, the world number 6, survived a massive scare from Korean Jung Young-shik in the round of 32. Mizutani was down 0-2 and seemed like he was due to be on the next plane to Tokyo. The Japanese superstar managed to recover to level the match 3-3, but then had to save 4 match points to finally win the 7th game 13-11 to book his place in the round of 16. This is a match you definitely want to watch in full. The Dutch Li Jie, number 27 in the world, upset the seedings by beating Du Hoi Kemp from Hong Kong, China in 4 straight games. Her reward? A clash with hometown hero Zhu Yuling in the next round. Li Jie's European counterpart, Romania's Elisabetta Samara, was not so lucky, as she lost to her former clubmate Cheng Yiqing from Chinese Taipei 4-1. China's unranked Mutsa earned her chance to compete for China, beating her higher-ranked teammates in the Chinese trials, and caused a major upset today by beating the world number 5 Kasumi Ishikawa in 4 straight games. She will now face Matilda Ekholm from Sweden in the next round. It was a way too early end for Dmitry Ovtcharov, but teammate and friend Patrick Franziska put a smile back on the face of German fans around the stadium and around the world after he beat the world number 8 Marcos Freitas from Portugal 4-1, an opponent that he had never won, get this, a game against before.
I never beat him before, and I think in my whole career, last 16 in World Championships. Yeah, if someone would tell me this before this tournament, I would sign it directly. So, yeah, I played the best match after my injury so far, and I'm very happy with that.
This match was followed by another Germany versus Portugal clash between Timo Boll and João Monteiro, who just became a father last week. Monteiro came within 2 points of upsetting the man that the Chinese have considered their greatest threat for more than 10 years, but it was Timo's experience in the end that got him over the line in a 7-game thriller. His emotional roar at the end showed the capacity crowd just how much this victory meant to him. The Japanese mixed doubles pair of Maharu Yoshimura and Kasumi Ishikawa became the first Japanese pair to make the mixed doubles World Championships final since 1977 in Birmingham. The Japanese duo were too good for the defending world champions and number one seeds from Korea DPR, Kim Hyuk Bong and Kim Jong, and defeated them 4-1. They will play the mixed nationality pair of Xu Xin from China and Yang Ha-un from Korea to become world champions tomorrow, after they were also successful in their semi-final. I'm sure you found this review amazing, but the full experience will give your goosebumps. Catch it all at ittf.com/ITTV or on your cell piece, tablet, or your crazy 21st century device at ittf.com/mobile.